There's no business like show business, like no business I know.
Where do you even start?
Everything about it is appealing.
Yeah, there's a lot there.
Be not afraid of greatness. Some are born great, some achieve greatness, and some have greatness thrust upon them. When I think about Rita and who she is and what has brought her to where she is, and greatness is what I think of.
Rita has been on the board of directors for ACT for 41 of our 45 years. She has also volunteered as producer or co-producer for 52 ACT productions. Some of those productions she did with the incomparable Jody Hecht. Now, Rita has been a costumer, a publicist, a set painter, you name it, she has done it.
I came to Aspen in 1969, and just to ski. When I first arrived, there was just a feeling of this is where I'm meant to be. This is home. This is where I'm going to plant my roots. I found my community. I found the people that loved Aspen too. And it became my life.
I am changed by having Rita in my life, because Rita has been in my life since 1968. So we go back. She's the one you call at 2:30 in the middle of the night when you need someone. First person I would call. It's a visceral thing. You feel her support. And that changes a person.
We met before I ever got involved in Aspen Community Theater, but Rita was one of the people that was instrumental in getting me involved, and it's one of the best things, obviously, that's ever happened for me in, you know, since I came to Aspen.
Rita is fun-loving, giving, caring, supportive, a true blue friend. Our friendship grew mainly through Aspen Community Theater, but she had an association with many people who worked at the Crystal Palace, where I worked for a lot of years. And then I was one of many people who Rita took into her house. Rita's home for wayward musicians is what I used to call it.
Rita and I have been friends for decades and decades. And it's all been because of theater. We both joined the board probably about the same time, in the early 80s. We've been a really very special team in my mind, a team that I've loved being a part of.
Rita worked for many years at Pitkin County Dry Goods. Rita was a sales clerk, but much more than that. Rita ran the leather department there. She was actively involved in making decisions.
She treats people like human beings, and she doesn't treat one person higher or lower than the other.
I have several friends who used to come every summer for the Aspen Music Festival who assumed that Rita was the owner of the store.
And so her gift, not only to hundreds and hundreds of customers and employees that she has mentored at Pitkin County, has been to thousands, literally thousands of guests to this town, that when they think of Aspen, they think of her.
I started with ACT in 1980. The first show I did was Night Watch, which was a spring show. And I actually got pregnant during that show, just because you might want to know. And then went on to produce many, many shows after that, up until now.
You two ladies are absolutely awesome.
We like this because you never know what you're going to have to do.
That's
turn
right.
We
like
pages, we
just fall on the floor, sell tickets,
right.
Whatever.
The fact that we were able to do the brilliant work that we've done over the years is because of so many amazing people. But somehow behind the scenes, somehow tucked in behind the the curtain and you know, not out in front getting the applause, but back there supporting and making sure the tickets and the costumes are done. It's always been Rita. Rita's just been there and just making it happen.
I wonder if you could count the hours that she has given to this town, because she has a passion for the theater, but that alone wouldn't do it. She has a passion for the project of it, pulling the people together, coaching them, organizing them, making them happy, and drawing out from them their very, very, very best. And I think people who have been in her plays would applaud her strongly for making them give their best, because she's giving her best.
My brothers would say it's because I'm bossy. In fact, when we were back for our little reunion, family reunion, we were trying to figure out where we were going to, what we were going to do. You know, when you have all these people trying to decide, my mom said, well, Dave's in charge. And then my middle brother said, well, we all know that Rita's the boss. So I decided where we were going to go. And I've been the boss ever since. And still am. It's a hard job, but yeah. Someone's got to do it.
When Rita asks you to do something, you just always say yes. You just can't say no to her. When you see somebody like that who is doing everything, you know, who leads by example, it makes you want to participate. You want to be part of this amazing collaboration.
Rita cannot be said no to. And Rita was there saying, this is going to happen, and I'm going to make it happen, and you're going to be with me when I make it happen. It's like, got it. We're with you.
A lot behind the sewing machine. A lot. On the telephone, or writing emails and asking. But a lot behind the sewing machine, and the costumes, and the fitting, and all. And she and Kathleen were, and other people worked together on that. I also helped often to work on costumes. But the detail that goes into these costumes is astounding. I mean, I think we're out here in the audience, they're up there on the stage. Who cares if it's, well, Rita cares. And it needed to be perfect always.
What's this costume?
This is the hood or the helmet for the poppy. So the whole poppy comes off of this. He's gonna look cute.
For me personally, having worked in higher stake professional situations, I can honestly say that her skill sets and leadership surpass many of the trained, paid professionals that I have had the pleasure of working with. She makes things happen.
What an amazingly strong woman. What a gifted soul in getting everything done and making sure that people are on board. And yeah, there are times where we'd all joke about, okay, somebody's a little bossy today. But you know what? You soon realized, okay, no, it's just, this is how it happens. This is how it gets done. This is how somebody can make it happen.
And if there's something for which she should be rewarded, it would be the selfless pouring out. And it's not just been a short time. We're talking decades that she has done this for so many people, and how she has mentored people and encouraged people to do what they do. But it's not ever about her. She has no reward for herself. She just pours it out for the enjoyment of the community. And I think that she instills in all of the people involved in producing a play that they are giving a gift to the community.
Community theater attracts people who didn't even know they were part of a community. I cannot tell you the number of times I've heard people who have gotten involved in shows who perhaps just moved to the Valley. We're talking about people who are landscapers, bankers, waitresses, nurses, doctors, all kinds of people who didn't even know that they possessed those gifts. And all of a sudden, they were a part of something that was bigger than themselves. and they were a part of community. And I think in current modern day Aspen, we desperately need organizations like this to prove that we really still are a community first and foremost.
Of all the shows that I've done with ACT, all the cast members that I've worked with, the friends that I've made, they've become friends for life in this community of Aspen. I owe Rita deep gratitude for that opportunity.
Lovely Rita, you have made all of our lives much brighter. Then in your spark, you dazzled all our days.
ACT has been your passion. Every show was stunning, smashing, inspiring you to go with folks to give it a go.
Walking in to see the theater, you can catch a glimpse of Rita.
Using all her energy to make a great show. Please accept this accolade. What a difference you have made. Lovely Rita Theater Maid.
This kind of endeavor takes so many people to pull off, from lighting, from orchestra, from costumes, backstage people, ushers, people who run concessions. There are so many people involved in this. And I think what impressed me was seeing Rita up on the stage in the spotlight, having just enjoyed a standing ovation, well deserved, in the Wheeler Opera House, but who immediately said, this is not about me. This is going to go on long after I'm gone.
I mean, the whole town was at her feet. She's up on the stage, you know? I thought, yeah, she deserves that.
It is widely rumored that Rita was born with a song in her heart. We all know that she has continued to sing the sweetest and the liveliest of songs throughout her life. Birds of a feather. In this case, birds wearing the most brilliantly colored feathers. Birds singing songs of all sorts. Birds that dance. Birds that bob and parade across our local stages have been drawn to her siren song for decades. She has coaxed, collaborated, collected, and culled them with her unique eye and splendid ear. She knows how to bring out the best in actor birds. She has encouraged us, and most importantly of all, continues to encourage us, to encourage people in this community to get involved. For she has given so many of us the courage to sing, dance, produce, and participate in our local community theater. She always tells us and shows us the show must go on. Rita, we love you. The whole town loves you.
First time that no one has listened to me when I said sit down. Anyway, I thank you so much for all of you being here tonight. I know there's a lot of people out here that have been on stage up here. There's a lot of people that have helped us in so many ways to make our community theater so great. And just the people that are just here watching the show, we couldn't do it without you. And you mean so much to all of us. Wouldn't be that much fun, would it, guys? This is really not about me. This is about all of you and how much you have contributed to our community and to the spirit of community. You know, that's what we are. And I just love seeing all of your faces out there tonight.
To sort of sloppily quote Wicked. Whatever way our stories end, I know you will have rewritten mine by being my friend. And of course, because I knew you, I have been changed for good. Bless you, Rita.
Thank you. Okay, So on with the show.